President Obama and Hillary Clinton wasted no time calling for more gun restrictions after the Orlando attacks. Here's some of what Obama and Hillary Clinton had to say when they found a TV camera.
Today marks the most deadly shooting in American history. The shooter was apparently armed with a handgun and a powerful assault rifle. This massacre is therefore a further reminder of how easy it is for someone to get their hands on a weapon that lets them shoot people in a school, or in a house of worship, or a movie theater, or in a nightclub. And we have to decide if that's the kind of country we want to be. And to actively do nothing is a decision as well.
We may have our disagreements about gun safety regulations, but we should all be able to agree on a few essential things. If the FBI is watching you for suspected terrorist links, you shouldn't be able to just go buy a gun.
If the FBI is watching you, maybe you shouldn't be able to run for president.
And you shouldn't be able to exploit loopholes and evade criminal background checks by buying online or at a gun show. And yes, if you're too dangerous to get on a plane, you are too dangerous to buy a gun in America.
I am completely serious. This is the same woman who last week said, delete your Twitter to Donald Trump. The same woman who deleted emails and is under that same FBI investigation she just mentioned. Oh my goodness. Who's advising this woman? Clearly they need me. Would guns have saved lives in the Orlando tragedy, or are guns to blame for the tragedy? I have never seen this level of hypocrisy ever. I am dumbfounded. Here to discuss is the executive director. I'm going to calm down and let someone else carry a little water here. The executive director of Gun Owners of America, Larry Pratt. Welcome back to America Trends. Good to have you.
It's good to be with you. Thank you so much. I share your passion about this because it's a bit much to watch Mrs. Clinton, protected by all kinds of well-trained, well-armed security personnel, tell the rest of us it's too easy for us to get a gun.
Such a great point. Such a great point, Larry. These are people whose their children's schools may be in a gun-free zone, but they have armed guards all over the place. Their homes have armed guards. Their work has armed guards. And yet they tell us, a citizen like me, that I should not have access to a gun. Let me ask you the hard question, Larry. These guns were purchased legally, according to all the reports that I've read. Is there some gun restriction that might be logical to discuss at this point?
Well, I think we'd better ask a prior question. Why is it that in view of the rather stunning statistic that all but two of the mass murders that have occurred in the United States since 1950 have been in gun-free zones, we don't hear the president talk about that?
No.
We don't hear Mrs. Clinton talk about that? We don't hear the political elite of either party talking about that,
right,
saying we've got to get rid of the place where these maggots tend to be attracted. It's like laying out dead meat for these people. We're telling them, come on in. There's nothing that's going to happen to you while you're here. Just shoot the place up. We don't really care about our kids. We don't care about our churches. We don't care about our malls. Gun-free zones are just ducky. How has that been working out?
Yeah, and do you wonder if you could have offered a loaded weapon to anyone in that place in Orlando that day, or in San Bernardino, or in countless other events like this one? Do you doubt that anyone would have turned it down, and that there would have been less loss of life if the citizens were armed as well?
Very possibly the last thought of some of the victims was, oh, if only I'd had a gun. Well, they were in a gun-free zone. And the argument is, well, but there was liquor being consumed there. Well, if it's a bad combination, I haven't seen liquor be used too often in self-defense. Maybe we ought to limit that in some way rather than self-defense devices.
And there's a point, because people can have a gun, and people will have a gun, and criminals very often have a gun. Look at Chicago, which Hillary and Obama don't ever like to talk about the number of deaths that happen every single week on the streets of Chicago. But
their hometown.
But here's the thing. If the killer had not had a gun, he would have had a bomb. He would have had a way to create the same carnage that he created. The only thing that could possibly have stopped him is a well-trained citizen who was also armed. And we would have seen less death. Do you agree?
Oh, there are places, I've talked to members of Gun Owners of America, there are places they simply will not go. When they see a sign that says no guns, okay, you're bad, but I'm not going there. And so if it means that merchant loses some business, better they lose business than our member lose their life. And so I think there's a lot of that going on, and it's going to be an increasing amount. And for some reason, the ruling class just doesn't seem to like the idea that folks like us can protect ourselves, do protect ourselves quite well when we have the opportunity to access weapons, but they don't want to talk about that because that means, well, maybe they're not so important. Meanwhile, don't ask about why they get such good protection.
Right. And you mentioned also, Larry, the fact that this is an inanimate object. A gun does not shoot by itself. So tell me the difference, if you would. Just illuminate this for me, because this is what I don't ever get. If we can't limit alcohol for people with a weapon to be able to be safe, then how come we all the time limit alcohol for people to drive a car, which causes many more deaths per year, more accidental deaths than a gun? And the car is also an inanimate object, which also, by the way, is the Quran. And nobody wants to talk about any blame that inanimate object might have either.
By the way, I think you've hit on a very important point. The Quran is basically what motivated that which happened here, that which happened in San Bernardino, two of our most tragic events in recent time. We can be very grateful that most Muslims don't pay a never mind to what's in their Quran.
Yeah.
Because if they read it, and happily, you're only supposed to be able to read it in Arabic.
Yeah,
we've got to.
You make such a great point, Larry. We've absolutely got to address that. I'm so sad we're out of time, but I want to have you back soon. Gun Owners of America, Larry Pratt, stay with us.